Hey everybody, I'm here today to talk to you about the top 7 tools that car owners need. In this video, I'm going to be going over 7 tools that if you're a car owner, you will likely need these. You should have them in your garage. Now, the only exception to this rule is if you never plan on doing anything to your car ever again. If you're in a situation where you're like, I am never gonna touch anything on my car, then you probably don't need any tools. You just need the phone number and the address of a good dealership or a good mechanic shop. But if you plan on doing anything, even the smallest things to your car, you should have all 7 of these tools. And the greatest thing about these tools is that they're actually not that expensive, and a lot of them are universal in the sense that you can use them for other things, whether you're doing work around your house or a renovation or anything like that. Let's get right into it. Tool number 1 is a jack. You got to jack your car up. If you're doing anything with your car, you have to jack it up. Now, it's important to know how to properly use a jack for your car. In addition, I would highly recommend investing in jack stands, good jack stands, just for extra support to be sure that you're absolutely safe. If you don't feel comfortable using a jack, don't use one. Jacks, in my opinion, for cars are only meant for people that really feel comfortable using it. Now, the first time, I would recommend using it with a professional, using it with someone that has done it many times, because, you know, it can be a dangerous situation. Use it with someone that knows exactly what they're doing, and then work your way up to independence while using a car jack. Tool number 2 is a socket set. Your car has tons of nuts and bolts that you're gonna need to use a socket set for. Now, socket set is very useful because if you're taking apart anything on your car or putting together anything on your car significant, it's good to have a socket set because you'll need to use it. Even if you're doing something as simple as changing your car battery, you should have a socket set. Invest in a good socket set with all of the different sizes that you need, simply because if you invest in a cheap one that has, like, you know, 10 sockets, you're probably gonna have to end up going and buying individual sockets to fill up the set anyways. So just spend the money, get a good set to begin with. The third tool that car owners need is a good work light. Now, if you're working only in the daytime, then you probably won't need this, but I would recommend getting a work light because you never know when you're gonna have to do something like swap a tire or change your flat tire at night. Now, the greatest thing about modern day work lights is that a lot of them are rechargeable and portable, meaning you don't need an electrical outlet. You can pull over on the side of the road, use your work light to change, to illuminate your working area on the side of the road, right? So you can charge it up, leave it in your trunk, make sure you recharge it every once in a while just to make sure the battery hasn't gone, and just use it. Very simple. Tool number 4 is a good set of pliers. Now, you can get one pair of pliers, but I would recommend getting a good set, simply because if you get one pair, you know, you'll probably be able to use them, and you can use like one pair of pliers for virtually anything, but it's easier to use certain pliers. Like if you use a full set of full width pliers versus a set of needle nose pliers, it's gonna be easier for the needle nose to get into the small surfaces and small areas, but it's gonna be easier for the full width ones to work on, you know, big heavy duty things. So just get a good set of pliers. They're good to have anyways in your home workshop regardless, okay? Number 5, tool number 5 is a screwdriver set. Now, you probably already have one, but if you don't, get a good screwdriver set. And I say a good screwdriver set. You can cheap out, get some horrible, you know, crappy screwdriver sets. They're not gonna be good. They're not gonna be insulated. They're not gonna be comfortable. Just get a good screwdriver set with multiple lengths, okay? You wanna get one that has shorter screwdrivers and longer screwdrivers. This way it fits all of your needs, okay? Tool number 6 that all car owners need is a good pair of gloves. That's right, I consider gloves to be a tool simply because they're gonna protect your hands from getting dirty, from getting calluses, from getting scratched, from getting cut and so forth. Get a good pair of gloves. And I would recommend that you wear a pair of disposable gloves. If you're working with like oil and stuff like that, wear a pair of disposable gloves underneath a pair of thicker gloves. This way, if the thicker gloves get wet or oil gets on them, your hands will still be protected, and the thicker gloves are gonna protect you when you're actually working with like the nuts and the bolts and moving the parts around and so forth. Last but not least, you might find this one surprising, but number 7 is zip ties. Zip ties are so useful for everything. Everything from holding your bumper in place to holding the wires together if you're wiring up some new stuff on your car or rewiring something. Now, here's the thing. My old car, the front bumper was falling off. I have a video about it somewhere in my channel, somewhere deep down in my channel. I made a video about, I believe I'd called it my banged up Civic Si. So take a look at it if you're interested. I actually had zip ties, like pretty much holding together the whole front bumper and grill. And it worked wonders for like years. I drove the car for like 5 years like that. Right? And I redid the zip ties every once in a while whenever I was working on it, because some of them would snap off after a few years of driving the car hard. But you know, zip ties are so useful for so many things. And that's it. In this video, I've gone over the top seven tools that car owners need. If you like the video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Let me know what you think down below as a comment. And of course, be sure to subscribe for more great car and driving videos just like this one. And that's all I have for you today. Thanks for watching.